So, Mr. Tsoumas, please go ahead.
Thank you for inviting me to speak in this event. In my brief remarks, I will first summarize the unique nature of this crisis and the new risks that banks could be facing if the pandemic continues. I will then touch upon some much needed measures to ensure the resiliency of the European banking sector going forward. This economic crisis is unique because it's global, it is exogenous to the banking sector, and it's based on non-economic factors that cannot be quantified using traditional financial risk management tools. Thankfully, the European banking sector was well capitalized at the start of the pandemic. Nevertheless, the sector's liquidity crisis is transitioning to a solvency crisis. As a result, the high credit losses, as well as the inflation of the risk-weighted assets, have led the credit rating agencies to have a negative long-term outlook for the great majority of the European banks. Of course, there has been substantial heterogeneity in the initial negative impact across European banks. However, if the pandemic continues well into the first half of the coming year, then any heterogeneity will be diminished, and we may see the emergence of new risks. For instance, there could be turbulence in the equity markets or the bond markets, as well as contagion effects across markets. Such issues would magnify the credit rating downgrades, as it would make the problem more difficult to be managed at the level of each bank or each corporation. In terms of resilience, the European financial services industry should take some critical steps. From an organizational perspective, banks should consider closing branches and restructuring their operations in order to reduce operational costs. Perhaps the best cost-cutting approach is to adopt new technologies. For example, such technologies could be used to streamline loss mitigation procedures, to improve risk modeling, and to offer a new customer interface. Many of these technologies have already been tested with great success in the United States, whose financial services have a strong track record in adopting fintech solutions. However, putting aside any measures that will be taken by European banks, at this point, there is a consensus that European economies need a powerful combination of fiscal, monetary, prudential, and administrative policies, both at the national and the international level. Since these decisive measures will shape the post-pandemic economies, the policymakers should carefully monitor the impact of these policies, which will inevitably create winners and losers across industries and across countries. Nobody knows how the pandemic will unfold and when it will end. That is why executives and policymakers must be decisive and agile in order for the European financial services sector to be resilient while transitioning to the post-pandemic world. Overall, this pandemic has created a unique economic crisis which should be dealt with unique measures. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Tsoumas.